Welcome everyone to the channel Physics Galaxy. So today we will solve one electronic question from CSR NET exam. So you can see the question on the screen. So in this problem, you have to find out the magnitude of the gain for the given circuit. So let us quickly draw the circuit diagram of the given circuit. So the circuit diagram given is So this is the circuit diagram given in this problem, and the data given here is the resistance RF is 200 kilo ohm, CF is 100 picofarad, frequency is 16 kilohertz, Cin 10 nanofarad. R in is equal to 20 kilo ohm. So these are the data given in this problem. We have to find out the voltage gain of this circuit. So let us denote these two resistances here by Z2 and these two resistances combined two resistances by Z1. So the modified circuit diagram here will be Z1, where Z1 is the input impedance for these two components. And Z2 is the impedance for these two components. And we can see that this is the inverting circuit amplifier of op amp, and this formula is V out is equal to minus Z2 by Z1 multiplied by V in. So my voltage gain will be nothing but V out divided by V in will be Z2 by Z1. So you have to find out the magnitude of the voltage gain. So if we take magnitude both sides, so this will give me magnitude of Z2 divided by magnitude of Z1. So let us find out Z2 and let us find out Z1 to find out the voltage gain for this circuit. So the Z2 in this circuit will be, Z2 is parallel combination of RF and CF. So this will be parallel combination RF, and the resistance for capacitance is 1 over J omega C. Sorry, this will be multiplied and RF plus 1 over J omega C. So if we simplify this expression, this will give me 1 plus J omega CF RF. So if we put the values of RF and different values given in this problem, so RF is given in this problem 200 kilo ohm. So if we put this value, this will be 200. If we transform it to in ohm, this will be in ohm. And omega is nothing but 2 pi f. F is the frequency. So frequency given in this problem is 16 kilohertz. So if we put this value, this will be 16 multiplied 10 to the 3. If we convert it to the hertz. And CF in this problem is nothing but 100 picofarad. So means 100 multiplied by 10 to the minus 12. And also, so this is the different data for this problem. So if we simplify this expression, this will give me 200 multiplied by 10 to the power 3. And also we have to find out, put RF here. So RF is 200 multiplied by 10 to the power 3. So if we simplify this expression, this will give me 1 plus 2.0096J. So if we further simplify this expression, so this will give me 200 multiplied by 10 to the power 3 multiplied 1 minus 2.0096J divided by 1 plus 2.0096 whole square. So this will give me 39694 minus 79769J. So this is the value of Z2. So the mod Z2 value will be root over 39694 square plus 79769 square. So this will give me 89099. So this is the value of mod Z2. So similarly, we have to find out the value of mod Z1. So Z1 for this problem, Z1 is series combination of this one and this one. So Z1 is R in plus 1 over J omega C in. So if I put different values here, R in given here is 20 kilo ohm. So this will be 20 multiplied by 10 to the power 3 plus 1 over J omega is equal to 2 pi F. Frequency is given in this problem 16 kilohertz, means 16 multiplied by 10 to the 3, and C in given here is 10 nanofarad. So this will be 10 multiplied by 10 to the 9 minus 9. So this will be 10 minus J995. So this is the value of Z1. So mod Z1 will be root over of 2 multiplied by 3 square plus 995 square. So this will be 20024. So the magnitude of the voltage gain AB will be equal to mod Z2 divided by mod Z1. So Z2 is 89099 and Z1 is 20024. So this will give me the answer 4.44. So this is the voltage gain for the circuit. So among the options, we can see that 3.5 is close to this one. So the answer will be option D, 3.5. So this is the complete solution for this problem.